It's my pleasure to introduce for his second lecture, Professor Chang-Shou Lin, who's speaking, as you remember from last time, on green functions, mean field equations, and the Painleve VI equation.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, so at the end of my talk, I show you the in the F0, so this F0, we have a three degenerate line, right? And this part is the omega 5. We have proved this part is simply connected because this is isomorphic to the triangulator, the second triangle. Okay, so I will show you why the degenerate curve is a continuous curve. Okay, the component only one and do not intersection. Actually, this to prove smoothness. Okay, but before that, let me go to the talk about the module form first. Okay, so we continue the talk about the module form. So now I define, let me give a definition of what we call pre-module form. Okay, if a function tau, holomorphic in tau for any fixed RS. Now we call this is a pre-module form. If RS is the n-torsion point, then the function, the holomorphic function is a module form of weight, some weight, okay? Then we call this pre-module form. So now, for the hyper-elliptic curve, I want to construct a pre-module form in the following. Actually, we consider, remember this is the hyper-elliptic curve, all components A1 up to AN is contained in the E tau. So we can define an additional map from YN to E tau, just a summation of AI together. So this is the first function, okay? So this function is a map from the Riemann surface to the E tau. And then I define a second function, it's a minimal function from the hyperelliptic curve to the CP1. So this is easy, we just summation all the component and take the value by zeta function, then minus each component, we take the zeta function summation together. So this is also a minimal function. Okay, so we have two functions. One is from the map from hyperelliptic curve to the E tau, and the other is from hyperelliptic curve to the CP1. This is a minimal function. Okay, so the first result I want to tell you is they are both degree is n times n plus 1 divided by 2. Okay, so so this result, for example, sigma n has degree or has such degree, then this means the function phi or hyperelliptic curve is the final extension of the function phi or E tau, and the extension, the degree of the degree actually is the dimension actually is n times n plus 1 divided by 2. So this is the degree. Okay. So now we want to find what's the primitive element of the extension. And we can prove. Okay, so I don't want to go to detail. We can prove the Zn. The Zn, I recall the Zn is defined by this guy. So Zn is this. Actually, Zn is the primitive element of the function field over the elliptic curve. Okay. So once we know Zn is a primitive element, so we can find a polynomial with rational coefficient in terms of G2, G3, pay sigma or any sigma in E tau and the pay prime sigma X. So this is the coefficient of the elliptic curve. And the degree in X, W degree in exactly equal M times n plus 1 divided by 2. And because this is primitive element of the extension. So automatically, we satisfy this equation. Wn, and you substitute x by gna, and this sigma uses sigma a, this additional map. Together, then this is zero, complete zero in the Yn tau. Okay? And Wn actually is homogeneous in G2, G3, P and P prime, and X. If we assign them the weight, so this weight is a module weight, module form weight. So G2 is 4, 6, and this is 2, 3, 1. Okay, so they are, Wn would be homogeneous. So now, after I have the Wn, then I can substitute. Remember, this is the Heck form. Right? We talked about in the previous, the last 3 minutes at my last talk. So this is Heck form. So substitute there, we call this is GRn, RSn tau. Okay? And actually, the RS could be anything over the C2, to a pair of complex number, but not in the them are half integer. Okay, so this is the cut of the half integers. Okay, so we have a Zn R n tau, and because this is already a module form if RS is a rational point, then you substitute here, and the third condition here imply if RS is a rational point, then this function is a module form. In the with respect to the gamma n of weight, now weight is n times n plus 1 divided by 2. Okay, so we have a new module form weight of this function. Okay, so how to relate this function, this pre-module form, and we want to study the non-trivial critical point of the Green function in the En tau. Okay, so this result. This means this basic result is if A is any non-trivial solution of the critical point of this Green function at tau equal tau zero. Okay, and the component, I summation of them together can be expressed into the E tau zero, this is R plus S tau zero. Now R S both are real. And this automatic, we can prove this is not in the Z square. Then the tau zero is the zero of the correspondent R S. Use R S here, this is zero of the pre-module form. Conversely, if I fix R S, okay, and you find tau zero is zero of this function, then there is non-trivial solution A at tau zero, such that this A, the all the components I mentioned equal R plus S tau zero. This is given. Okay, so this is important. We just this theorem transform the non-trivial solution into the zeros of the ZNRS tau. And remember, this is a holomorphic function in tau. So this implies the result, if I allow tau deformation in upper half plane, then the non-trivial solution cannot suddenly disappear, cannot suddenly appear at some tau zero. This is impossible because this is holomorphic function. We always, if you have zero, when RS change a little bit, then tau in a neighborhood, it has a solution. So here we use a holomorphic in tau, this property. Okay. And the most important thing is this function, is this result. The function, the pre-module form we just control, has a simple zero. Okay. So once you know this simple zero, then for any RS, locally, you can find the zero. This is well defined. Okay, at least locally. The conjecture I tell you is just say tau is locally 1-to-1, except for a finite set of RS. Okay, so let me say one word about this conjecture at this point. And actually, suppose tau is not locally one-to-one. Okay, we can, from here, we can derive is the derivative of R and the derivative of S. These are two linear dependent vector, hence the determinant equal zero. So this determinant of the derivative give one real analytical function. On the other hand, using the integrability of the equation, I didn't write here, okay? We can derive another independent of the, another real analytic function. Those RS is satisfied by this real analytic function. So right now, if we can prove these two real analytic functions are not dependent, then we can prove, then it follows the solution. We can prove the conjecture. This means for any finite point, except a finite point of R, RS, then the bifurcation point cannot happen at the non-trivial solution. Okay, so this is the, unfortunately, right now I cannot prove the these two linear algebraic linear analytic curve are not independent, yeah, because the expression is very, very complicated, even n equal 2. But I think this is the right direction to work in. Okay, so let me tell you, we all finish all the preparation for talking about for the application of Painleve VI. So let me go to the Painleve VI. So Painleve VI is quite an ugly equation from here, right? With four parameter alpha, beta, gamma, delta, alpha, beta, gamma, delta. Okay, even myself, I cannot remember correctly the equation. So how to solve the equation? You know that there is a, so is how to solve it, the equation. Usually, we solve it by initial value delta, right? So if I fix the T0, this is not in the 0, 1 infinity. And I put the lambda 0 is not in the 0, 1 infinity, T0. And then I give a solution. Initial delta is the lambda 0 and the lambda plus derivative at T0 lambda 0, say lambda 0 prime. Okay, so now you under this assumption, then we know the, you plug the initial data, this part is all smooth, is okay. So you can use the initial value problem to solve the nonlinear equation locally. Okay, then you use the analytic continuation to extend this lambda as a minimal function. But unfortunately, those nonlinear equation always has a branch point. Okay, so this is a multiple value. Okay, so let me tell you what the Painleve property is. So a nonlinear PDE is said to have the Painleve property if its solution has neither movable branch point nor movable essential singularity. That means any solution whose branch point only at the singularity of this equation. Let me look at the singularity of this equation. This is only lambda 0 and the lambda 1. So this do not depend on the solution. But lambda t, this depends. So we don't count it. And so for this equation, Painleve property say any solution lambda t is a multiple minimal function if t is not 0, 1 infinity. And if there is a pole, okay, if there is a pole, the pole must be outside of this 3 point, must be, if there is singularity, the singularity must be pole. Okay, so now, this space, okay, the universal covering is the upper half plane. So it's better we leave the t and the lambda t solution to the universal coupling. So this is the lifting. So let me define tau t respect tau by the E3 minus E1 and E2 minus E1 and the lambda. Okay, I define lambda, I define pay p tau. If you know lambda, then I define the pay p tau by in this formula. Okay, of course p is not well defined because there are two choices, plus or minus has the same thing. But you just choose one branch. Okay, so the most important thing is the p satisfy. If lambda satisfy this Painleve equation 6, then p satisfy the following equation. This equation is much more simple and very beautiful one. Okay, so this alpha 0, alpha 1, this is come from the alpha minus beta and gamma of this number. Okay, so this is we call this is the elliptic form of the Painleve. So this elliptic form. So this elliptic form is quite nice. When I was saw it in the paper by Manin, then I think this is the equation I want to study it. Okay, in any case, the advantage of the solution in this form, this means the pay function, pay and with the plug p tau there and consider this function of tau, okay, then this is a single value for tau in H. But the p tau has a branch point at those tau zero such that p tau zero has the branch point. Okay, so now let me introduce the most important theorem in the history of the Painleve, outer or called outer Painleve and outer earlier 20th century is proved by the Hitching. Okay, so this is a Hitching result. Now Hitching result is alpha, all alpha beta, all alpha, okay, all alpha is equal 1 over 8. So this is particularly Painleve equation, we call the Hitching equation. So the theorem, the following theorem is proved by Hitching. So let me explain this to you. For any complex pair RS C square, okay, not in the half integer, and let me define P in this way. P, pay P is defined by the R prime S plus this form. Okay, so the right hand side, once you given RS, the right hand side for any tau, this is well defined. Okay? Of course, except some point is infinity, that's fine. This is just a discrete point only. Okay? Then I define the pay PRS tau. So if I define this way, then P always satisfy this equation with alpha I equal 1 over 8. Okay, so this is very important. This is the first explicitly expression of the Painleve solution of Painleve equation, except a very trivial one, we call Picard solution. Okay, so in any case, we get this solution, and this is, I think this is very remarkable. You see. From here, you see the denominator, this term, exists our Heck form, right? Denominator, this is our Heck form. Okay, so as I told you, this function has the Painleve property. This means if this guy equal, if there is a pole for at the tau zero, so where will it come from pole of the P? The value would be go to infinity, right? So this means this zero could be zero, right? This must be zero, okay? So when for some RS, you tau z at tau zero, this is equal zero, but the numerator is not zero, then this tau zero must be pole of the pay the left hand side. Then Painleve property tells us this singularity must a pole. So imply not only pole, it's a simple pole. So imply this zero is a simple zero. Okay, so the only thing we have to prove is the denominator and the numerator cannot vanish at the same time. If we cannot, we prove they are cannot vanish at the same time, then we get the any zero of this function is any zero is simple zero for this function. So this is what I mentioned. And this is true for any R S is complex. As I told you, the simple zero of this Heck form, as I know, can only prove by through the Hitching theorem. Okay, so this is very remarkable. First example, I tell you how we can apply the Painleve VI equation. Okay, so this is a theorem I just mentioned. Okay, so this is very, very, very nice. Okay, now I'm going to prove why the degenerate line is smooth. So this also comes from Painleve equation. Okay, so now, so this line is what line? Is the half period, the Hessian or half period is zero for those tau, okay? So now I compute the Hessian. Okay, then after some calculus, you know this part is positive, so forget this. And this determine equal minus the sum of the positive function and the time, a holomorphic function, image part holomorphic function in tau. Okay? So this means this image part equals zero if only if tau is in this kind, in this line. Okay, so I want to show you at least this, you see from my picture, any two degenerate curve do not intersect each other. So this is very important. Okay, in any case, I want to show you how to prove this smoothness. This smoothness just come from this function as a function of tau is locally one-to-one. Okay? So I want to show you why this function is locally one-to-one by Painleve equation. So this is the theorem I want to tell you. Okay. It's a very well known to any important feature of the Painleve equation is that any solution of lambda t govern the isomorphism deformation of some linear OD. I didn't tell you what's the linear OD. Okay, I think I cannot say here because it requires so much notation. Okay, so for the Hitching, I just tell you for the Hitching solution, lambda is what's lambda ist. Remember, I have the P, right? I define P, then I substitute into the lifting. So if this P is, I define this lambda ist, okay? The important is to see the monotomy group, okay, is generated by this RS. So the RS actually give you global data of monotomy representation. So the monotomy representation for the Hitching solution completely reducible. Okay, but we know there are other solutions where the linear equation is not completely reducible. So what kind of solution it would be? Okay, there are actually four family, and those family come from so-called Riccati solution. So they are for Riccati equation for the Hitching equation, okay? So you just go to, it's easy to find it because any Hitching equation related to a Hamiltonian, and you just derive it from Hamiltonian system. Okay, so the complete list of solution to these four Riccati solutions are given by 6T2, okay? By subtil P tau is P, is in given in this form. So first, let me give you first the 6.2 again. So 6.2 is here, right? You given P, whatever you give P, and this you get a solution lambda P, okay? So what P is? You can, there are four family. OP. What C can be any constant up to infinity, okay? Any complex number, including infinity. You define four family. One is by this one. And this function actually equals this guy. And another is a more complicated from k equal 1, 2, 3. So you have this. Okay. So for example, in 6.6, you give the lambda infinity. Put C infinity here. You just get the lambda is a minus. Because k equal eta 1, if you plug into the 6.2, you get this guy. Okay. So Painleve property imply eta plus E1, this function has simple zero, for example. And you can put the C infinity here, you get another eta 1 plus EK. Okay? So the question, I want to prove this function is locally 1 to 1. This is simply equal to the derivative of this function not equal 1 divided by 2 pi I. Okay? And after I prove this, then I can prove this function, as I told you, has only one zero for any fundamental domain of gamma 2. Also, this is not module form. Okay, so let me tell you how to do it. It's actually use I use C, substitute C for any tau zero, fix a tau zero. For example, if this is not a zero, okay, then I use C define this one. And plug into, and for example, you use this C is that guy. Remember C, then tau equals C is pole of the pay. Okay, then this is the symbol pole implied this guy is not zero. In any case, you substitute there. Also, you can use the C equal more complicated that is equal zero. Fix the tau zero, you make C make this zero. And then substitute this to the function we study. Then we can prove. So we can prove the derivative is not zero. Okay, but in this way. So let me repeat to you it's very strange. I don't think this is coincident. It's very strange, is the derivative of at the branch point, okay, the major part actually always come from the Riccati solution or the Painleve equation, and this part always come from the complete reducible solution. So this is a very although I can prove it, but I feel mysterious even to me. Okay, so let me. So once I prove that, then I can prove these things. Okay, so this is the first part of application of the Painleve. So let me go to the high n greater than 1. So in this case, I should use the Painleve equation, not the 1 over 8, but use alpha 0 is 1 over n plus 1 square. Okay, this n greater than or equal 1. And all alpha equal 1 over 8. Then we have a generalization of the Painleve equation. Okay, so this is we can find a polynomial, okay, in X with the sigma, okay, and so this is also rational polynomial in the G2, G3, okay, such that for any RS, if I define P through this formula, very similar to the Hitchin equation, Hitchin solution. So I define P, I get the PRSN, and once I fix the RS, this psi is the well-defined function, so I can define P. Okay, and then I have the numerator is PN plus 1 is this polynomial. And the remarkable is the denominator is two of the those functions multiplied together. Okay. So the most important thing to prove this is the simple pole is the if both of the numerator and the denominator cannot manage at the same time. So you have to prove this. Okay, then let me tell you about this, okay? So we can prove any two polynomial, this has no common root for any sigma. Okay, then if n is not is less than zero, then conventionally we ask this equal one. And any two polynomial of a sequence of W, they cannot have common root. This is very important. I will tell, yeah, this is for the future study. Okay, so let me repeat again. So I can find a solution. This P is satisfied Painleve six alpha I of the, this is satisfied the elliptic form of this function with alpha y, alpha zero equal this guy, alpha I equal 1/8 for 1 to 3. So this expression is the solution of this. And it's very nice is the, we have those function. Okay, so the how to prove all this theorem? This theorem is, there are three ingredients. One is so-called Okamoto transformation. Okay, and the second is the theorem I developed in the previous section. And the third one is we have studied the behavior of the singularity, behavior solution near its singularity. Okay, the behavior of singularity, we will give us the monotomy data. So it's very important. In any case, I just tell you some of the Okamoto transformation. So Okamoto transformation actually is a birational transformation of solution of the Hamiltonian system. We know that each Painleve equation associate Hamiltonian system. So if you have two Painleve equation, that means you get two systems of Hamiltonian equation. Then Okamoto transformation is not a birational transformation of Painleve equation, but the solution of Hamiltonian system of this one. Okay. So the formula for this Okamoto transformation is very complicated. So it's very difficult to obtain the exact form, the form we show here. It's very difficult to, because we don't know how to determine the denominator by the Okamoto transformation. Okay. But we need to use our theory in the previous section. And but how, where is the advantage by using the Okamoto transformation is that we can prove one and the two. So this is by induction using the Okamoto transformation. So Okamoto transformation allow us to inductionally construct something, some important the form. Okay, so this is what I want to tell you. Okay. So now, let me example to tell you. So basically, all the PN, I didn't tell you how to express control this one, right? And not yet tell you how to compute all those forms. All the existence was mentioned, discussed in the previous sections. Okay, then there are several ways to do it, but the most essential way is to apply so-called Kreciba-Enzas. Kreciba-Enzas is when he studied the KDV related problem, he do this, okay? So you have, is use the Kreciba-Enzas. So our example below use the Kreciba-Enzas to compute those examples. For example, let me tell you n equal 2. So z, the primordial form is the K is the Hecke form. So K cube minus this one. And the pay, okay, this should be, this should be one. I mean one. This is also one. So this would, so n equal two, we get the P. We get the, n equal two, we get the Z two. But instead we, for the P, we get the one. So this is the, generalized, the formula for general equation. So this is P. the 1P I told you. So this is, okay? Let me keep, so it's going to be very complicated if n is increasing. So let me just tell you, n equals 3. So we have z is the sixth polynomial in x. So this k is the Hecke form. So this is already very complicated. And the p now is the such things. Okay, so you can continue to compute a few n, and then the formula would be very, 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 very complicated. Okay. So now, after I told you, we talk about the non-trivial solution, but now it's important, as I told you, important is the behavior near branch point of the hyperellipticity. So the Green function on the e tau n, so we compute the non-trivial trivial solution now. So we want to compute the hashing. So you see the hashing is the 2n times 2n matrix. It's very complicated. Okay, so let me give you a non-trivial one, n equal 2. So as I told you, there are five branch points. So these five. Then I can compute the determining. Okay, this is equal, just forget this. This is all positive term, but you see there is also the same image part of the sum function, image part of sum function here. Okay, so C. So we have to show, if we want to prove the curve tau such that this is equal zero, I want to prove this kind of curve is smooth. Okay, then I have to prove this function is simply, is locally one-to-one. So I have to prove those two functions are locally one-to-one. So how to prove it? This is just the application of Painleve VI. Okay, so as I told you, I have to prove this is this function, both are locally one-to-one. Here I just make a remark. Square of root g tau 2 tau is not single value for tau h. So we should cut along the line of tau equal, real tau equal half, but b less than square root of 3. Because along this line, this is zero, this is negative. Hence, we can choose a continuation just for this g2. Then Then their intersection, of course, now it become is not a smooth point. In any case, I want to show you of the. So all the degenerate branch point is union of those curves together. But there is one isolated point. So this is very interesting because the hyperelliptical respect to this number is non-smooth. Okay? So I want to prove the theorem 7.2. So it's equivalent. I have given a solution of Painleve equation, but this kind of solution is coming from the Riccati. So now become very, very complicated. So I have given P solution. Let me give P1 is given by in this way. Okay, and all this way. All C could be any complex number include infinity. And I get this P, then I substitute to the previous formula, 6.2. Okay, here. So I have P, if I get a, not this one. So if I get a P, okay, then I substitute this formula again, then I get a solution, lambda. Each, any formula of the P then give you a solution of this guy. Okay, then let me go back to. Okay, so here. So I have four family of solution, right? Then I get the four family of the lambda, and I substitute any c make this zero. For example, I use this formula, make c equal zero, make fix tau zero and make this zero. Okay, then I get the for this function, I get a tau at the tau zero is simply connected. It's simply pole. Then zero, this zero is simply zero. Okay. Then we can prove the. So for let me for example. For example, if I use this guy, okay, if I use this guy, then phi plus minus the particular one, this function would be locally one to one. Okay, so I use the simple zero. So this is the phi plus minus here. This function. Simple. Okay. So I don't go too detail this, but just assure you, even n equal 2, all the computation seems not so easy, okay? But the fix, everything fixed for, yeah, right now I only compute n equal 2, n equal 1 for Painleve, but for my original equation, n equal 2, everything fixed. And for n equals 3, I think it's also true. From my experience, but I didn't compute it right now. Okay, so let me leave this. So now I want to tell you the proof of the. Remember, I give you a picture. This is very early. I have n equal 2. Remember, I have the. So this is our f zero. Okay. And there is a 10 curve. Remember, there is 10 curve. And something like that. Okay, there is a very complicated the things. This is for n equal 2. Okay. So I want to prove the actually, I still have time, right? So let me, I can go back to the previous n equal 2. Let me, I'm talking about this. It's very difficult to say. Yeah, here. So I want to prove this. I want to prove this for you. So I have the C23, C plus minus. What C23 means? C23 means the branch point, omega 2 divided to 2, and omega 2 divided. This is a degenerate curve. Degenerate critical point for the Green function, okay. So this is C23. You cannot see it very clear. C23 actually here and go to here. There are two C23. One is here and one is near here. Here. So I want to prove C23. The degenerate curve for this branch point has two components, and each component is unbounded, okay. And the F0 fundamental domain divided by 10 curve or rows into several divisions. Then I want to prove this region is 1, okay, and this is 0. Okay, in any case, I will go to the proof, but let me tell you this region from this line C13 up to here and go use and the bound by C plus and C12, this domain. Okay, this domain, please remember, I will prove. There is the fourth triangle will go to that one. Later, I will tell you. So this is fourth triangle. Remember, I have a triangle here. 1, 2, 3, 4. This guy will go to there. And the triangle one will go to this part. Triangle one will go to this part, 2, 9, okay, and then this together. So this part, this and this part would be the third triangle. And for second triangle now is no solution. Okay. So this is what I want to tell you. So let me go back to the proof of this fact. Okay, so now the first thing is I have to prove, as before, I have proved this function, gi is tau, right? This is 2, this is by typo, this is 2. g2i is tau, not g2, on the boundary of the h. Okay? So I have to prove this. Oh, no, they asked, not for me. I have to prove this. But this is equivalent to a non-existent of the equation now is the 16 pi at the singularity, the right measure there. And for the rectangle torus, this result is a highly non-trivial PDE result. Okay, this is very difficult. Much difficult than a pi. Okay, so you have to prove this. And then, as I told you, you can study the, so this first type, first proof, first step, and then you study the asymptotic when tau go to the three cusp. Then this is the same as before. If RS in those triangle, open triangle, then the boundary, the limiting at the three cusp not zero. Okay, so then I use the same idea. Okay, then you use the same idea to prove this result. So first, I call it step one. This function has a zero in F, if only if R is in the first triangle and the third and the fourth, okay? Furthermore, for each RS, then I get a unique zero in F zero. So this is F zero. Okay, so now I can define a map from I's triangle to the F zero. I call this tau I. Okay. As I told you, we have to use the computer asymptotic limit and the prove. The asymptote do not manage it if not on the boundary. Okay. So now, the only thing I have to compute, I have to use the module form theory. Now it's more difficult because now is this is the weight three, and then I use the six torsion point. In any case, we compute it, and we know the for this case has a zero for six. Torsion point, then if only if R is equal 1 over and this 3. So this one in the first and this equals 3 and this equal 4. Okay, so this I prove something that I told you gamma 4 to this kind of boundary. Okay. So now I want to so let me assume, as I told you, let me assume the formula. The conjecture holds except a finite many RS. So then we can prove, suppose this step two, then we can prove conjecture 1.3 actually holds for every RS. And the map actually is one to one onto from this guy onto this part. Okay. So the proof is it's basically we can show some uniqueness for some particle tau zero. And because this finite, S finite set, then use this and the finite set, we can prove this set is empty. And then we prove that any one of them, any curve do not bound any bounded domain. This is what we see in the numerical simulation. We can prove this, and then we prove this each component is 2. Okay. Then we come to the five part, the image of them. Actually, three of them intersection is empty. If not, then this means I have six, for some tau, I have six non-trivial critical point, which degree is minus one. However, the total sum is the, however, so you each one minus one, so you have six, then you get minus six. So you index formula, this is equal one, okay? Then the branch point at the most I have five. So you cannot have any degree of five minus six cannot equal one. So we get a contradiction. So step 5 implies the tail of the non-critical point less than or equal to. And the last step, we will prove the image of different two is not empty and is connected. So we prove the figure 2 in my numerical simulation. Okay, I will stop here. So thank you for your attention. Oh, I have said many things. It's not used usually for that identity. You cannot use. You have used the whole theory. Yes.
Do you have to prescribe the asymptotic behavior like law?
Yes. Because there is singularity, so you must have the solution. You must log g. Okay. Behave like log g near singularity. But we prove there are no such kind of solution. No, any solution at the singularity must derive major for that kind of equation. Okay.
Do some of these questions involving the green function and mean field equation make sense on the inner surfaces of higher genus?
I don't know. I need to use elliptic function to compute. So for higher genus, then you don't have any equation. And any function we know to compute there. So it's, we still need something for the, some elliptic function to compute to green function. Also, those property defined in the half plane is very difficult to compute. You know, for any elliptic function, if this guy is dependent on tau, it's very difficult to do the derivative around tau. This is extremely hard. So usually we cannot do it. So you have to use the other method. So this is why the Painleve equation is very, very important for doing this. I never do the computing, of course I do, but not so extensive about the derivative around the tau. Yeah, okay. Thank you.